Hello everyone, welcome to another lecture of Swing application development. So in this video we will learn how you can use components in your main window, okay, mainframe. So now we will work with buttons first, then okay, we will start with the buttons. So go to your mainframe.java. We created the mainframe. This is the logic code for our mainframe, and the UI is in the mainframe.form. So this is our UI, okay. So collapse this tab, and then this is our mainframe. So we want to add a button in this frame, okay. So these are the components. Click on J button and drag this button and drop into this frame, okay. So this is a button. Now save it and back to your mainframe.java. You can see there is a private member of the mainframe is J button, that is button 1, okay. So we can change this button name from the mainframe.frame. So click on the button and click the field name and change this button to hello world. Save it and then back to mainframe.java. So the value hello space word is not valid identifier, okay. So here a lesson: whenever you set the field name should be a valid identifier according to the Java rules, okay. So now I will set hello world like this. Save it and then back to your mainframe.java. Now this is the identifier for our button, J button, okay. So now you want to click on this button and perform some action, okay. So how can we do that? So back to your mainframe.frame and then click on the button, right click on the button and then create listener, okay. Create listener. So click on action listener. When you click on the button, this action listener will listen the event and run the task whatever you want to perform, okay. So click on the action listener and it will create the action listener for this button. Click on OK and you can see here hello world.add action listener and JVM IntelliJ IDEA pass the object of the action listener, okay. Action listener interface and it passes the anonymous inner class and it created an object of the action listener in class, okay. Action listener class, action listener interface, and it created the subclass of the action listener and instantiated at this point, okay. So now whatever we write in the action perform method, it will run when we click on the button. So right here system.out.println print a message you clicked on button, okay. Save it and run this application. Now click on button and then you can see in the console window you clicked on button, okay. Click again, okay. So this is how we can create buttons on our Swing application and create the action listener for this button, okay. If you don't want to set action listener from the frame from here, okay, so click on it and then go to listener and then remove it from here, okay. Remove it, save it. You can see there is no error perfectly. So we can add the listener from our code also, okay. So create a method here. This is another method to create listener. So create another method, private word set action on button, okay. Then create a action on button. So hello world dot add action listener and then pass new action listener, okay. Now override this method. So system.out.println manually set it, okay. Save it and then click this method from the constructor, set action on button. Save it, run it. Now you can see this is button and click on button. So manually set it, perfect. So there are two options to set the action listener on the button: from the mainframe.frame, okay, and then from the mainframe.java manually, fine. So this is enough for this video, and in the next video we will see about the layouts.